When we were planning to go to Sicily, the planners were very seized with the need to be quite certain that we landed on the beaches in the right way. I used to say, no, the real thing to do when you open up a campaign in a new theatre of operations is to decide how you're going to develop the battle in that theatre. And then you work backwards to the beaches and ensure that you land on them in a way which is going to fit the master plan from end to beginning. Mm. And then you land on the beaches in a way which will bring that about. Then I think the other thing is that I, in my planning, always thought and planned at least two battles ahead. The one I was about to fight and the next one, so that I could use the one I was about to fight, the success gained in it, as a springboard for the next one. And I believe that is necessary, and that is exactly what I found was not being done when I was taken home from the Eighth Army to England to begin planning the Normandy adventure. The same thing there.
Too much preoccupation with the beaches, you mean?
Too much preoccupation with landing on the beaches without having first determined the strategy of the campaign in a new theatre of war. And that led, the strategy I advocated, which was agreed, was first decided, and then I and my staff began to devote our attention, working backwards from there, to how we would land on the beaches.
Well, now that plan, which you as the commander had decided, for a man who justly prides himself on the clarity of his language and expression, how did it happen, Field Marshal, that you never seemed to have got President Eisenhower, or General Eisenhower, as he then was, the supreme commander, to understand your plan for Normandy?
Well, you know, that is one of the things in my military life which I've never understood myself, because this strategy for Normandy was a perfectly clear-cut thing. It was to land and then to so direct the operations that we drew the main German strength onto our eastern flank and then broke out on the other flank, the western flank. And Eisenhower had agreed to that, and it had been put over in a series of conferences in London many times. And I thought he understood it.
General Bradley understood it.
Yes, now that was an interesting point. You see, Bradley was a battlefield general and had done a lot of fighting in North Africa and Sicily and so on, and he understood it.
Seeing you every day, too, in Normandy.
That's very true. He's seeing me every day. I used to go and visit him, or he visited me, and so there was no question about it. Eisenhower had not done a lot of fighting. In fact, the first time that he ever saw a shot fired in anger, in my knowledge, would be when he landed in North Africa in the Operation Torch.
But now, of course, in your plan, Field Marshal, you'd said that you were going to take Caen on D-Day. Is it a fair criticism to say, as some people have been saying since the memoirs have been published, that, of course, you didn't get there on
D-Day?
I
failed. Criticism is often hurled at me that I failed.
Yes.
Now, that brings you down again, I think, to the conception of the operations. The acquisition of territory on the eastern flank of the bridgehead in the Caen sector was not really important. What was important there was to draw the maximum number of German divisions, and especially his armor, into that flank. The acquisition of territory was important on the western flank. And sometimes you quite rightly draw attention to an accusation that is very often hurled at me, that I ought to have taken Caen in the program on D-Day. And we didn't. I didn't mind about that, because the Air Force, of course, used to get very hit up because I didn't go further down towards Falaise and get the ground suitable for airfields. I didn't bother about that. It would have meant enormous casualties in doing it. It wasn't necessary. Now, I could reply to that criticism by saying that on the American front, the line from which the breakout was finally launched, which was the line of the St. Lô-Perrier Road, should have been captured in the initial plan by the American First Army on D plus 5. That's the 11th of June. And they didn't actually capture it till the 18th of July. But I've never returned the charge with that accusation.
Till now?
Till now. Well, and only now because you raise it.
Well, of course, in the end, it worked, so that's the main thing.
It worked. That's the main thing. It did work. I quite agree, but I never have understood why it was that Ike said in his dispatches that when the British failed to break out towards Paris from the eastern flank, the Americans were able, because of our flexibility, to take it on the western flank. And I've always thought that was rather an unfair criticism against Dempsey and the Second British Army.
Well, you won in Normandy.
We won. It doesn't matter.